Hello friends, this is Professor Parth Thakkar and in this lecture we are going to discuss our case number 2 and case number 3 for the fins. In our previous lecture we have already discussed different types of fins, purpose of fins and heat transfer rate in the case of infinite long fin. So let's start with our case number 2, which is considered that heat dissipation from fin at the tip is insulated. The tip is insulated here. In actual practice, the fin are not supposed to be that much long that the end tip temperature is nearly equal to the surrounding temperature. But here we can see that the heat transfer from the tip is very negligible as compared to the heat transfer from the remaining fin surface area, because whatever heat transfer takes from the fin to the surrounding, it would be by convection mode. So the surface area of the fin as compared to the tip is much more larger. So the tip surface area or the heat transfer from the tip is very negligible as compared to the remaining surface area of the tip. So that's why here it is written that it is considered to be insulated tip. In practice, there is no insulation on the tip, but the heat transfer from the tip is very negligible. That's why it is considered to be, there is no heat transfer from the tip, so it is considered to be insulated. So as similar as previous case, this is our base wall whose temperature is TO, which is much more higher as compared to the environment temperature. One fin is attached with this wall. So at x is equal to 0, the temperature of fin is nearly the temperature of the wall, so that the TO. As we are moving from left to right along the length of the fin, the temperature will decrease, because whatever heat is conducted from this wall to the fin, simultaneously that much of heat is rejected continuously to the surrounding by convection mode through this surface area of the fin, so that the temperature will decrease along the length of the fin. And after some length, the temperature of the surface of the fin is nearly equal to the surrounding temperature, so that the heat transfer from the tip is nearly zero or nearly negligible as compared to the heat transfer from the remaining surface area. So suppose this end is insulated, so in that case the dT by dx is equal to 0. How? Because we know that heat transfer rate is generally calculated by Q is equal to minus K dT by dx. If value of Q, value of heat transfer rate, is equal to 0, then dT by dx would be 0. That's why at the tip dT by dx is equal to 0. When x is equal to L, it shows the location, this location at the tip, x is equal to L. So for x is equal to L, dT by dx is equal to 0. This is our boundary condition. Our first boundary condition is the same as case 1. When x is equal to 0, the temperature of fin would be TO, so that the temperature difference at this point would be TO minus TA. TA is an ambient air temperature. So the temperature difference is TO minus TA, because at x is equal to 0, our temperature of fin, this is T, which shows the temperature at particular location. When we put x is equal to 0, we are here. So the temperature of fin is TO. So the temperature difference is TO minus TA. So that theta is theta O. This is the base temperature difference. So that theta is written as theta O. Now our second boundary condition, when x is equal to L, so that at this point dT by dx is equal to 0, because I repeat once again, because at the tip we considered here as insulated end, so there is no heat transfer rate from the tip of the fin, so Q is equal to 0. Now we know that the equation of Q is equal to minus K dT by dx. If in this equation, if you put Q is equal to 0, then K and A both are constant. So dT by dx is equal to 0. at which point at x is equal to l. So at x is equal to l, dt by dx is equal to 0. This is our second boundary condition. So we have to use these two boundary condition to find out value of c1 and c2 for the general equation. This is our general solution which we have already derived in our previous lecture, that theta is equal to c1 e raised to mx plus c2 e raised to minus mx. Applying our first boundary condition, if we put x is equal to 0 and theta is equal to theta o, our equation would be c1 plus c2 theta o, because e raised to 0 is equal to 1. So this is our equation number 1, c1 plus c2 is equal to theta o. Now we have to use our second boundary condition, in which there is dt by dx. So first we need to find out what is the value of dt by dx. So we know that from this equation, theta is equal to c1 e raised to mx plus c2 e raised to minus mx, we can write, what is theta? Theta is t minus ta, it is temperature difference. So t minus ta is equal to c1 e raised to mx plus c2 e raised to minus mx. To get the value of dt by dx, we need to differentiate this equation with respect to x. So differentiate this equation with respect to x. So t becomes dt by dx. Ta is a ambient temperature, surrounding temperature, which is constant. So differentiation of Ta would be 0. So dt by dx is equal to c1 is constant, e raised to something. Differentiation of mx would become m, e raised to minus mx, e raised to minus mx. Differentiation of minus mx would be minus m, so minus m c2 e raised to minus mx. Now we have boundary condition for dt by dx is equal to l. So instead of x, we need to put l, and by putting l instead of x, you can write d0 instead of dt by dx. So this is our second boundary condition, dt by dx is equal to 0 when x is equal to l. Okay, so from this equation we can write that c2 is equal to theta o minus c1. If you put c1 at right hand side of the is equal to, it will become minus. So c2 is equal to theta o minus c1. Putting this value of c2 in this equation, we will get c1 e raised to ml instead of c2 theta o minus c1 into e raised to minus ml as it is. Simplifying this equation by multiplying e raised to minus ml into this bracket, so minus theta o e raised to minus ml plus, because minus minus, plus c1 e raised to minus ml. Now take c1 common from both this term, c1 e raised to ml plus c1 e raised to minus ml, c1 will common, so in bracket e raised to ml plus e raised to minus ml. Put this minus theta o e raised to minus ml to right hand side of is equal to, so it will become plus theta o e raised to minus ml. More simplifying this equation, you will get value of c1 as theta o e raised to minus ml. This term is going to be upon of this term, so e raised to ml plus e raised to minus ml. Now put value of this c1 in this equation to get value of c2. So now your c2 is theta o as it is minus, instead of c1 you can write value of c1. So in this equation theta o would be common, so equation would be 1 minus e raised to minus ml plus e raised to ml plus e raised to minus ml. Cross multiply this term with 1, so e raised to minus ml and e raised to minus ml will cancel out. What will remain? Theta o in bracket e raised to ml upon e raised to ml plus e raised to minus ml. So this is our c1, this is our c1, and this is our value of c2. Now putting both value of c1 and c2 in our this equation, in our standard general solution, putting value of c1 and c2, this is our c1, this is our c2, putting this c1 and c2 in this equation, you will get theta instead of c1 this value, instead of c2 this value, you will get this equation. E raised to mx and e raised to minus mx will remain same. Multiply this e raised to mx and e raised to minus ml in this equation. You know e raised to x into e raised to y, you can write e raised to x plus y. So here e raised to minus ml into e raised to mx, so e raised to minus ml plus mx, so that m will be common, so in bracket it will be x minus l. Theta o would be common from this both term, and putting it in upon of theta, so the equation is simplifying in this form. Now we know that if we divide by 2 to both this term, it would become cos hyperbolic ml minus x and cos hyperbolic ml, because we know that cos hyperbolic ml minus x is equal to e raised to m l minus x plus e raised to minus ml minus x divided by 2, and cos hyperbolic ml is equal to e raised to ml plus e raised to minus ml by 2. So we can divide both the term by 2, so we will get this equation. Okay, so this is the simplified form for the case of insulated tip. Now our concern is to find out heat transfer rate in the case of fin which is insulated at the tip. So same logic we will apply for this case, same as case number one. If we want to find out how much amount of heat will transfer if we use this kind of fin, then we can easily find out by using conduction equation, because we know that whatever amount of heat will conducted from this wall to this fin, that much amount of heat will rejected by the fin surface area to the surrounding by convection mode. So to find out that much amount of heat transfer rate, we can easily find out by using this Fourier equation minus k dT by dx at x is equal to 0, because whatever heat is gained by the fin from this base material, it will be from this location, so that at x is equal to 0 the conduction will happen. Now from this equation, from we have this equation T minus TO is equal to TO minus TA in bracket this cos m cos hyperbolic ml minus x upon cos hyperbolic ml. So this is our equation which we have just derived. We want value of dt by dx, so forget dt by dx, we need to differentiate this equation with respect to x. So we will get dt by dx, differentiation of TA would be 0 because it is constant, TO minus T is constant, cos hyperbolic ml minus x, differentiation of this term would be sin hyperbolic ml minus x, and differentiation of minus mx would be minus m. Cos hyperbolic ml will remain same because there is no x in this term. So this is dt by dx. We want dt by dx at x is equal to 0. So putting x is equal to 0 in this term, so we will get sin hyperbolic ml upon sin hyperbolic ml upon cos hyperbolic ml, this minus m would be okay. So the equation would become minus m TO minus TA sin hyperbolic ml upon cos hyperbolic ml, so it would be tan hyperbolic ml. So this is the value of dt by dx at x is equal to 0. Putting this value in this equation, we will get q fin k ACS will remain same, instead of this minus and this minus, minus minus plus, so TO minus TA tan hyperbolic ml. Now we know the value of this constant m is under root of HP by K. There is already K, so it will becomes under root of HP KA TO minus TA tan hyperbolic ml. This is the heat transfer rate in the case where it is assumed that the tip is insulated. In case number one, we assumed our fin length is infinite. So it is case of infinite long fin. In that case, heat transfer rate was under root of HPK TO minus TA. In this case, only 10 hyperbolic ml is deeper. Okay, so this is our case number 2. Mostly case number 1 and case number 2 is most important. But let's take view on case number 3, which is heat dissipation from a fin losing heat at the tip. Or we can consider this case as a fin with a short length, with less length. If we have a fin whose length is not that much long, then what will happen? The heat will also loss from this tip of the fin. Okay, so at x is equal to L, a length of the fin is very less, so that there is some heat which is conducted up to this tip, and this tip will lose the heat to the surrounding by convection mode. But we know the amount of heat which reaches to this point is by conduction. Only by conduction some amount of heat will reach to the tip of the fin, and that much amount of heat will reject to the surrounding by convection mode, because this is a solid boundary and in the surrounding there would be some fluid. So between solid boundary and fluid there would be convection. So to find out amount of heat which is conducted from this base up to this tip, we have equation minus k dt by dx at which location at x is equal to L. That much amount of heat will reject to the surrounding by convection. So for convection mode of heat transfer, we have equation H A delta T. So this is H A. A is a surface area of this tip, or we can say that a cross sectional area. The both are same for the tip. Temperature difference is T minus T A. T is the temperature at this tip, which is unknown right now, and T A is the ambient or surrounding temperature to this tip. The case, the boundary condition number 1 will remain same. At x is equal to 0, the temperature of the fin is TO. So that T minus TA temperature difference is TO minus TA. So we can write down at x is equal to 0, theta is equal to theta O, and the temperature difference is TO minus TA. Our second boundary condition for this case is at x is equal to L, so that at the tip, the heat is whatever heat is conducted, it is same as the convected to the surrounding. So minus k dt by dx at x is equal to L is same as the h a t minus t a. Whatever heat is conducted to the tip is convected to the surrounding. Now if we rearrange this equation, because for the tip whatever the surface area is same as cross sectional area, so this cross sectional area of the conduction heat transfer at and surface area for the convection heat transfer will same. So we will cancel out this cross sectional and surface area. Rearranging this equation, this is this is dt by dx. If we put this k in upon of h, so and this is the temperature difference, so instead of t minus ta we can write down theta. So this is theta, so it will become minus h theta by k. Dt by dx at x is equal to L is equal to minus h theta by k. We can write this from this equation. Okay. Now we are going to apply this both boundary condition to get value of constant C1 and C2. We know our general equation is theta C1 e raised to mx plus C2 e raised to minus mx. Applying boundary condition number 1, we will get C1 plus C2 is equal to theta O. To get value of dt by dx, we need to differentiate this equation. Similarly as case 1 and case 2, we will get dt by dx as m c1 e raised to mx minus m c2 e raised to minus mx. Now we have condition for dt by dx at x is equal to L. So we need to put instead of x, we need to put L instead of x. So e raised to ml e raised to minus ml and is equal to h theta by k from our second boundary condition. Now simplifying this equation, in this both term m is common, so putting m common and in upon with k, so it would become minus h theta by km. From this equation, simplifying this equation, we know the value of theta. Theta is c1 e raised to mx plus c2 e raised to mx. So instead of theta we can write c1 e raised to ml plus c2 e raised to ml, because this is for x is equal to L. So instead of x we can write L. Now in this equation we know that from this equation c2 is theta o minus c1. So in this equation instead of c2 we can write theta o minus c1, so whole equation becomes in form of c1. Now put c1 terms in one side, so c1 e raised to ml, multiply this e raised to minus ml in bracket to more simplify this equation and get c1 constant from the all the terms. So by more simplifying this equation, in this equation theta o e raised to minus ml will be common, so in bracket 1 minus h by km. So from this equation we will get value of c1, which is theta o 1 minus h by km e raised to ml upon e raised to ml plus e raised to minus ml plus h by km e raised to ml minus e raised to ml. We have to put this value of c1 in this equation to get the value of c2. So putting value of c1 in c2, so theta o minus c1, this is value of c1 which we have just derived. So theta o and theta o will common, so 1 minus this whole term, multiplying this with 1, so you will get this kind of equation. after more simplifying this equation, after opening all the brackets, you will get this kind of equation, and in this equation e raised to minus ml plus minus e raised to minus ml will be cancelled out. Then in this equation, yes, this is h by km, minus h by km e raised to minus ml and plus h by km e raised to minus ml will also cancel out. So what will remain, e raised to ml will common from this both terms. So e raised to ml, taking e raised to ml as common, in bracket 1 plus h by km, the upon term will remain same. This is the value of c2. Now we have to put value of c1 and c2 in our general equation. This is our c1, this is our c2, and this is our general equation. We have to put this value of c1 and c2 in this equation. So after putting value of c1 and c2, we will get this kind of equation. And in this equation, theta o is common. So putting theta o out of the back, out of the bracket, I mean, let's take it upon a theta. So theta upon theta o would become like this. So this is the, you can see from this equation, if we put divide by 2, if we give divide by 2 here, also to this equation, divide by 2 to this equation, divide by 2 to this equation, we will get, as this is cos hyperbolic ml minus x, this will become cos hyperbolic ml minus x, this will become h by km cos hyperbolic ml minus, sorry, sine hyperbolic ml minus x, similarly this cos hyperbolic ml, and similarly this sine hyperbolic ml. Now let's find out the heat transfer rate in case number 3. We will apply same logic in case number 3, same as case number 1 and 2. If we want to find out heat transfer rate, we want to find out how much amount of heat will conducted from this location, so that from at x is equal to 0, what amount of heat transfer rate would be by conduction mode, because whatever heat is going to be transferred to the fin from this base material, it is through conduction mode because they both are in a physical contact. So the equation is minus k dt by dx at x is equal to 0. Now we have just derived the equation, this equation, which is t minus ta upon to minus ta is equal to cos hyperbolic m l minus x plus h by km sin hyperbolic m l minus x upon cos hyperbolic m l plus h by km sin hyperbolic m l. Now we want value of dt by dx at x is equal to 0. So to get dt by dx, we need to first put this to minus ta at this location. So our equation will becomes like this. Now we have to differentiate this equation with respect to x to get dt by dx. So now differentiate this whole equation with respect to x. So dt by dx, differentiation of this ta would become 0 because ta is environment temperature, ambient temperature. So differentiation of constant is 0. So only dt by dx is equal to to minus ta is a constant. Cos hyperbolic ml minus x, so differentiation of this term would be sin hyperbolic ml minus x, and differentiation of m minus mx would be minus m, so minus m sin hyperbolic ml minus x. Similarly, differentiation of this sin hyperbolic ml minus x is cos hyperbolic ml minus x, and differentiation of this minus mx would be minus m, which is written here. In this term, there is no x, so cos hyperbolic ml plus h by km sin hyperbolic ml will remain same. So we will get this equation after differentiation. We have dt by dx at x is equal to 0, so we have to put 0 instead of x. So when we put 0 instead of x, we will get minus m sin hyperbolic ml minus m h by km cos hyperbolic ml, cos hyperbolic ml plus k by m sin hyperbolic ml. So m is common in both the terms, so taken as common. Now in this equation, if we divide by cos hyperbolic ml, so here sin hyperbolic ml by cos hyperbolic ml, it will tan hyperbolic ml plus h by km, this would become 1, this would become 1 plus k h by km tan hyperbolic ml if we divide by cos hyperbolic ml. And if we put, we know the value of m is under root of hp ka, So if we put under root of h, this whole value dt by dx x is equal to 0 in this situation, dt by dx at x is equal to 0, replace this dt by dx at x is equal to 0 by this equation, we would get this equation k acs minus minus plus. So I have not shown minus sign in this equation. K acs instead of dt by dx at x is equal to 0, we have just put all this stuff. So dividing this by cos hyperbole, dividing this upper term and lower term by cos hyperbolic ml, we will get this tan hyperbolic ml plus h by km, 1 plus h by km tan hyperbolic ml. And we know instead of m we can write under root of hp by ka, so it would become under root of hp ka to minus ta as it is. Dividing this term by cos hyperbolic ml, so it will become tan hyperbolic ml plus h by km upon 1 plus h by km tan hyperbolic ml. So this is our case number 3. For exam purpose and for general purpose, case number 1 and case number 2 are most important. As you can see, in case number 3, the value of constant c1 and c2 are too large, but for numerical purpose we need to remember these two equations, heat transfer rate in case of case number 3 in case of short fin, and this equation of theta by theta o. We need to remember these two equations to solve the numerical of the fin. So that's it for the today. Thank you so much.